On December 12th, Devin Townsend played the Camden Roundhouse, and I was there to see it. A lot of your viewers are Devin Townsend fans, aren't they? They certainly are. High chance of you getting recognised at that gig, I'd imagine. So no one recognised you at all? Probably too intimidated, weren't they? That's why. But I mean, you know, no one. Didn't want to be recognised, mate. I was there to enjoy a gig, when I don't want to be talking to fucking dirty people. Should we just have a review of the gig then? Yeah, review the gig, that's all it's about. Don't matter, don't matter, don't matter. Right, okay then, so Devin Townsend at the Camden Roundhouse on December 12th. What a gig this was. Spoiler alert, I think it's best to get straight into it. I have got some footage to be able to show you guys of some of the songs. First up, it's worth mentioning that the opening band was Haken, a band who have definitely been making headway. And I think they put out an album last year called Vector, if I remember rightly, which I did not check out. And all I can say is, from what I saw at the gig, they're definitely a band worth checking out. Great band. Now, I actually got to the gig a little later than I wanted to, and there was quite a queue trying to get into the place. So it took me a while to get in, and unfortunately, I only managed to catch the last two songs of Haken. But I'll put one of them up now. I really enjoyed what I saw of this band. Phenomenal musicians, very good musicians. Very entertaining, very energetic, very prog, definitely. Very complex musicianship. Sounded great, I enjoyed the sound. It sounded pretty good in the Roundhouse, actually. I've been there before and it was a little muddy, but it was pretty good today, last night. Well, I think the thing that I found most enjoyable was how much they were clearly enjoying themselves. They got a great response from the crowd. Really, really seemed to go down well. So Haken, definitely a band that I'm gonna have to check out and get into and see what they're all about. Definitely one to check out. It's also worth pointing out as well that the gig was being filmed. The last time he played the Roundhouse, I believe it was when he recorded the Retinal Circus, which was quite the spectacle, and that went out on a super deluxe edition. But yeah, there was filming going on in the place. They had cameras set up all over the place, all the cranes going on. Very motley crew. Man, it is a goddamn windy day. Almost as though it was the next day. So now we get to Devin Townsend himself, and the band enter the stage one by one, starting out with Haken keyboardist Diego Tejeida, who starts by making a cocktail for each one of the members to receive as they walk onto the stage. And he's soon followed by Markus Reuter on ambient guitar, Mike Keneally on guitar, Nathan Navarro on bass, the fantastic Morgan Ågren on drums, the absolutely sensational Ché Aimee Dorval, who backs Devin up in vocals and guitar. And then we get the one and only Devin Townsend himself to an absolutely rapturous applause. And they're also backed by a three-person choir of Samantha and Anne Preis and Arabella Packford. The set itself was very much themed after the introduction to Empath, Castaway, where it feels like a Hawaiian beach, a bar on a Hawaiian beach. Before they actually get into any playing, Devin gives a bit of a speech about the current climate, particularly in Britain, as it was an election. As on this particular day was actually the election. So there's all sorts of shiznit going on. Not fun. But basically the overriding sentiment that he was giving out was that let's just have fun for one night. Let's forget all the worries.
Yeah. Everybody good on this side? These are our friends here, buddy. Yeah. Let's hear it for Haken tonight, everybody. Come on. So for the next 2 hours, I invite you all to go on vacation with us. Enjoy.
But now on to the music, as we get into the first song, Borderlands, which contains one of my favourite riffs off the new Empath album. Borderlands, a fantastic start to the evening. We continue into Evermore, a fine rendition of it. But then we segue into a heavier section with War. Things continue with Sprite, and the talked introduction is done by the three-piece choir before the rest of the band kicks in. Not such a big fan of this song, to be quite honest with you. I felt things dipped a little bit at this point, just in terms of energy. It's not a bad song, just not one of my favourites on the album. But this was followed by an improvisational jam between Devin and Morgan, who came to the front of the stage and had a little drum kit up front, both he and Devin improvising off of each other. And as Morgan was still at the front of the stage, they went into a four song run from the Key album, and this was probably the highlight of the gig for me. I absolutely loved this. Started out with Coast. Yeah. At this point, Ché Aimee Dorval joined the stage again, because this started a run of songs that she actually performed with Devin Townsend on key. And the next up was Gato. Continuing the key theme, we had probably the highlight of the show for me, Heaven Send. This was absolutely amazing. Ché Aimee Dorval did such a great job on this. She really, really commands the stage. Album is definitely something that I'm going to be doing a review of in the new year, without a shadow of a doubt. Absolutely loved that album. Didn't film anything for this one because, quite frankly, I was too busy enjoying it. But this segued into Ain't Never Gonna Win and Deadhead, which is just always a crowd pleaser. One of my favourite songs. Such a highlight for many fans, I'm sure. Again, didn't film any of that because I was too busy enjoying it. That's a lie. I actually filmed 2 minutes of it and realised that I hadn't actually pressed record. Next up we had Why, and this time Devin took to the stage wearing a dress. I think at this point as well there was a speech where he was just sort of saying about how he was just going to be who he was, and that's what everybody else should be, and stop trying to pretend to be somebody else. I don't think it had anything to do with the dress, but yeah, I'm going to show this next section as well because he got some real crowd participation going on the beginning of this song. It's really good. Why? Next up we had Lucky Animals, and Devin made sure that everybody was involved in this one.
All right, so here we are. I've just sang my nuts off and I've only got 3 more left. So my friends, I'm going to take a bit of a break in this next song, but that requires you to give me some crowd participation. I didn't want to say participation, watch this. To give me some crowd participation. Are you ready, my fucking heavy metal friends? Because I can tell, I can smell it. It is a little diverse in here. To give me your jazz hands! Excuse me. So here's how it goes, okay? We need you all to participate. It goes... I'm going to keep your animals for now, but I'll give them back, I promise, because it is so beautiful. One more time. Please, 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 my fragile ego depends on it.
Every time the chorus comes, we expect to have that happen. It's more awkward for us than it is for you, I guarantee. Morgan, hit me in the shitter, buddy.
Up we had Genesis, which is by far my favorite track on the Empath album. I was kind of curious to see how this one would go down live because there's so much going on in this song, and I was actually really impressed how it went down, so we'll check out a bit of that now. And then the end of the gig for me was actually Spirits Will Collide, where Ché Aimee Dorval, the three-piece choir, and Devin all got together and performed it acoustically. It was really well done. It worked really well as an acoustic version.
So, like I say, I don't know if any of you have lost any friends or loved ones to depression. Right? Yep, same. And so the whole idea with Empath, the whole idea with this show, the whole idea with all of this is the fact that just a bunch of human beings are just like, come on guys, let's just try through it all to try and make something beautiful for the sake of the fact that we're not going to give up, right? Thank you so much for not giving up, honestly. That's a huge part of it. This next song is from Empath. And this is a song about them. This is dedicated to anybody who's lost, anybody to depression, anybody who's going through it right now. Specifically tonight, guys, please hang on. Please hang on. This is called Spirits Will Collide. Thank you.
unfortunately, I had to leave the gig at this point, so I was able to get home. But from looking at setlist.com, apparently they play Disco Inferno, which I would have absolutely loved to have heard that. I'm sure that would have been a good time. And they finished with Kingdom, which I would have absolutely loved to have seen, because I think anyone who's done a reaction video to that will know how phenomenal Devin's voice is on that song. Where am I going? But yeah, so that was the gig. I had to cut it a bit short, but I saw the bulk of it, and I have to say it was probably the most enjoyable gig I've been to in a very, very long time. I don't drink anymore, and one of the only times that I do miss it is at gigs, because it's kind of hard to let yourself go and really get into it, you know, a live show. But that wasn't the case at all on this gig. I just really enjoyed it from start to finish. That was the whole point of it. He stressed a couple of times during the gig that he just wanted to entertain people. He just wanted to give people a good time, and that's exactly what he did. And there was another thing that I really noticed as well. Maybe this is a change in how I am with music. I wasn't bothered about the technicality. Obviously, there are times, obviously Devin is an incredibly talented, not just composer, but hang on, let me get in this. God damn, let me get in here. Yeah, not only is he a phenomenal composer and musician, vocalist, all the rest of it, we all know what an incredibly gifted and technical guitar player he can be. And there were moments where he was really shredding, and I wasn't really wowed by it. And I don't mean that in a bad way, I just wasn't. I think the overriding thing that I got out of it was just how fun it was. Everybody on stage seemed like they were having a blast. They were just enjoying themselves, and they were just there to entertain and have a good time. And yeah, that's exactly what they did. It was good. It was really good. I enjoyed it a lot. Fun time, fun night. If you haven't seen Devin Townsend live, definitely check him out. I believe he's touring again next year, and I think he's going to be doing some of the Strapping Young Lad material, if I'm not mistaken. I believe he said he was going to return to some of that, so that'll always be great to hear some of that. And Haken as well. Absolutely fantastic. As I said, I only caught the last two songs. Got straight into the wind again, Ben. Yeah, I only caught the last two songs of them, but from what I heard, it was very enjoyable. Really dug it. It was fantastic. Well, I am now going to head off and attempt to film part one of my top 10 albums for the decade. So there's a lot to get done, so I ought to go and do it. Hope you enjoyed this. If you did, drop a like, drop a comment. If you haven't already, subscribe. If you enjoyed it that much as well, share it. Let other people feel the love. But yeah, there's people coming up on me now. That's always awkward. I think I've lost them. But till the next time, I'll see you then. Whenever that may be. Be in a couple of days, probably.